All right, hold up. So apparently the first Minecraft LEGO set came out over 8 years ago, and somehow during this time they never made a LEGO Minecraft game. Two franchises that are all about building and showing your creativity. But instead, LEGO decided to make a new I Can't Believe It's Not Minecraft, and something that seems like an actual LEGO-branded Chinese knockoff. Now before they go off and make another LEGO Batman, or like their 10th Star Wars game, let's see what an actual LEGO Minecraft game might look like. Now if you're like me, and you've watched other game dev videos making Minecraft, you'll know that most people try to optimize it by hiding some of the faces of the cubes. I realized that I don't know how to do this, and I decided to just see what would happen if I placed a bunch of blocks. I quickly realized why this isn't a good strategy. But I didn't want to quit on this idea, so I remembered hearing about something called Unity Dots, which is short for the Data Oriented Technology Stack. To you that probably means nothing, but that's fine because I don't get it either. All I know is that using dots, I can place more blocks without playing the game at 2 frames a second. While researching how to use it, I came across a channel that showed how to use dots to make a game like Minecraft. The only problem is that his tutorial stream is in Mandarin, and I can barely even speak English sometimes, so it wasn't much help. Luckily, he put out the project on GitHub, and I started reading through all the code to understand how it worked. Initially, the project only spawns in one chunk when the game starts, so I learned how it worked and made it so that I could make an infinite chunk generator. I placed invisible triggers all around that would spawn a new chunk when the player crossed it. Eventually, if the player runs for too long, there will be too many blocks for even dots to handle, so I had to make sure to delete chunks every time a new one spawns in. My first attempt didn't really go so well. For some reason, it was only removing one block every frame, and somehow managed to skip over some blocks. A chunk this size has roughly 7200 blocks, which at one block per frame would take around 2 minutes to finish. Imagine how boring Minecraft speedruns would be if you had to wait 2 minutes every time you walked into a new chunk. Eventually, I got it to a point where I could remove a lot more blocks per frame, and it wouldn't miss any, but it would severely reduce the frame rate. So, yeah, bonus points to anyone who can figure out how to optimize this further. Now, if I were to just replace the blocks with Legos and end the video here, it would be a really boring video. So I decided that I would try to replicate a lot more features from the actual game. First, I started working on fixing up the character. I fixed the speed of the character, the jump height, and the field of view to make it feel a lot more like Minecraft. I also made it so that the field of view change when running is more noticeable. Pressing F5 in Minecraft will change the camera view from first person to third person, so I wanted to add in this feature too. I got a model of Steve on Sketchfab, and broke it up into pieces so I could have just the arm. Then I gave him some really cool tattoos to show his support of the channel, and I made an animation for the arm in first person mode when you're digging or attacking. After that, I made animations for the entire body so I could move around in third person mode. When moving the camera around in third person, I made Steve's head look in that direction, and I also made the famous crouching animation that just makes you think that you'd like to play Minecraft today. After finishing the character movement, I decided now was a good time to add in the LEGO blocks before adding in gameplay mechanics. It's actually really simple to make this change. I got a model of the LEGO brick, and then dragged it into the project so that it spawns LEGO bricks instead of cubes.
Hold up, wait a minute!
Wait, no, that's not right. Much better. I also added a new skybox that I found to make it look a little better. Now at this point I've basically recreated the creative game mode, but I think it would be a lot more exciting to recreate the survival game mode. The first step is to change how blocks are destroyed. Initially the project came with a way to destroy blocks, but it would destroy them instantly. I made it so that blocks take longer to break, and I also added a little effect to show that you're breaking the block. I also made it so when the block finally breaks, it drops materials and you can pick them up, but doesn't actually give you anything yet because there's no inventory. So at this point the next logical step would be to add an inventory, but for some reason I decided I wanted to add enemies next. I grabbed a model of the zombie, started making animations, and made its head track the player's location. Then I needed to make it follow the player, but I don't have any experience making bots or AI, so I literally just made the zombie make a beeline for the player. Since the ground isn't flat, it would get stuck every time it ran into a block, so I also had to make sure that it jumps if it gets stuck. Now as scary as a zombie jumping in your face might be, it isn't very threatening since it doesn't do any damage yet. In one of my previous videos, I made the mistake of not doing enough research. So this time I'm going to make sure I figure out the correct health and damage values. The player has 10 hearts on the health bar, where each half of a heart represents 1 health. Zombies also have 20 health, but unlike the player who attacks for 1 damage, zombies will do 3 damage if the difficulty is set to normal. The player will also take 1 additional fall damage for each block over 3, so a drop of 4 blocks does 1 damage, 5 blocks does 2 damage, and so on. With all of this in mind, we can start to add in the health bar. I found a sprite for the heart and made 2 more versions, one that is half full and one that's empty. Then I made a health bar using these sprites to show how much health you have left. I added a hurt box to the zombie's arms to make it hurt the player, and made it so that the zombie could take damage in return. After taking damage, the zombies will turn red, and will straight up just disappear when their health reaches zero. But if the player reaches zero health, the death screen will pop up, and you'll have to respawn. Since the player can take damage, they also need a way to recover health. I added in some cows so that they could drop food for the player. I'm not really sure how to make them move around idly, so I made it so they just stand there, menacingly. At this point, there would be no way of picking up the food unless I made an inventory, so I made a very basic inventory at first to pick up the food. I made a hunger bar the same way that I made the health bar, and looked up how the hunger mechanic worked. I was actually surprised because there was a mechanic about saturation that I didn't know about before. But anyways, I made it so that the player will lose hunger when they do certain actions, like running, jumping, and attacking. But if the player is at full hunger, they will recover health fast, and near full hunger, they will recover health slowly. If the player's hunger drops to 6, then they lose the ability to run, and running out of hunger completely will start to slowly drain the player's health. The cows drop raw beef, which will recover 3 hunger points, so you can slowly regain hunger by eating. Since I started working on the inventory, I decided to finish it by expanding on it. Now the player can walk up to any blocks that drop, and they will be added to the inventory. There will also be a number next to the item indicating how many you have left. Picking up another block adds to the count, and placing a block removes from the count. I also made it so when a certain block is active on the toolbar, the player will be holding that item in their hand. For blocks, I just place them on the end of the player's hand, and raw beef will hide the player's hand and you'll only see the beef. Similarly, if the player were to hold a sword, you would only see the sword, but let's not get ahead of ourselves yet. I made a very simple crafting menu so that the player can make a few things. I started small by only having 3 craftable items, planks, sticks, and a wooden sword. Now the player can mine some wood from a tree, make some planks and some sticks, and then turn it into a sword. The sword will help kill mobs faster as it does more damage. A wooden sword does 4 hearts of damage per attack, so it can kill a cow in 3 hits and a zombie in 5 hits. The last feature that I decided to add was the day-night cycle. The skybox that I found has a texture that easily changes it from day to night by offsetting the position of the texture. With this, I just made a simple timer to progress the time in the game. As time progresses, the value of the texture offset increases, and the light will dim as it gets closer to nighttime. During the daytime, I made a bunch of cows spawn in. Every time one is defeated, another one spawns somewhere else on the map. Then at nighttime, the cows will disappear, and zombies will start to spawn. I had to set a limit because having too many zombies made my game start to lag. But for now, let's just watch some gameplay of LEGO Minecraft. See ya.